Good evening, everyone. I haven't gotten the official okay, but it's time. So it got quiet and it makes me nervous. So we have to get rid of the quiet and get some joy in here, okay? Too quiet is too quiet. So you clap, laugh, cry, sing, make noise, celebrate. This is a celebration. First thing I should say, I guess, is welcome. Welcome to the 53rd annual Festival of Spirituals. Yes. Yeah. So, who has been here? Who's attended more than 20 years of spirituals? Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Back here. Yeah. 25? 25? Yes. 30? Yeah. Yeah, as you can see, I've made some great friends over the years doing this, because I've been doing it for a long time myself. I don't even want to say the year. About as long, almost 30 years, yes, myself as well. So every year is different, and this year is different because it's our first time back since the COVID crisis. We're back. We've had offerings online for the last 2 years, but this year is the first year back. So thank you guys for being here to help us celebrate. And thank you to the singers. It's a very diverse group. It always is, but just so you can kind of see, Genesis, what do you do for a living?
Ultrasound.
Cardiovascular ultrasound. There you go. Ultravascular ultrasound. Wait. Cardiovascular ultrasound. I should know because I've had one recently. So, all right. Brandon, what do you do for a living? All right. Great. Yes, Troy. Would you mind sharing what you do for a living?
I am a recording studio technician for the Oklahoma Library for the Blind and Disabled.
Okay. Awesome. Great. Yeah, I just want, and Nia, tell us about you a little bit.
I go to school.
Yeah, so we have students, we have professional singers, we have community singers, we have people who love singing, we have people who particularly love spirituals, and so it's always a diverse group that we have, and I'm very proud of that fact, because this is an amazing art form that if you haven't sung it, it's very unique in the approach. It's very Brandon is one of the finer teachers of that, as you will hear with his choir at Northern Oklahoma College that will be singing earlier, a little bit later this afternoon, this evening. So I'm nervous. I'm not used to being here. I'm usually back behind the stage. So I want to give a little of what's happening. All music is a form of expression, and the spiritual is very much that. Spirituals are, by definition, Christian songs created by African Americans that born of the African American slave experience. Originally an oral tradition, today being expressed through unique arrangements by various composers and arrangers. This uniquely American art form is recognized as a distinct genre of music. The duality in the lyrics is one of the things that makes spirituals unique. Often simple and repetitive, they were and still are a genuine expression to and about God. But they also contain hidden messages to communicate in code. For instance, home would often refer to heaven, but it also covertly meant any free country or place where one could live in freedom. And I think we're all experiencing that again. And now, you know, we're looking across the world and we're seeing how these spirituals apply yet to the African-American experience. But it's a shared experience. The church, it's a part of our church history as well. The gospel train and Swing Low Sweet Chariot, which are probably, if you are familiar with spirituals, you probably know those too. They contained veiled references to the Underground Railroad. And death was at times actually a reference to hope, to the one who takes me away from sorrow and pain into a promised land, whether it be literal or spiritual. Tonight we are here to celebrate, not to be sad and not to have long faces, okay? Because I see some of you will still have long faces, so. To hear, to feel, to honor the roots, the origins, and the evolution of the spiritual. It's not just what, but who we are celebrating and honoring. The people who created this art form out of their experiences and expressions of pain, sorrow, hope, survival, and a connection to God and one another. So, there are certain words that reach into the whole of humanity that transcend across culture, race, and religion. In the eternal words of Baal Shem Tov, forgetfulness leads to exile, while remembrance is the secret to redemption. And that those are eternal words. Those work for all of us. It works for these spirituals. It works for each of us individually, no matter what our background is. Tonight, we're going to begin and end with it's not Christmas, if you hadn't noticed. But there are actually a lot of, one year, and we probably will do this again soon because it's been several years, and I think it went really well. There are Christmas spirituals there that just for that season. Mary Had a Baby, Sweet Little Jesus Boy, Go Tell It on the Mountain. And we're going to start tonight's program with Go Tell It on the Mountain. We're going to end with Go Tell It on the Mountain. And when we end this evening, you are welcome to join in and sing the choruses of Go Tell It on the Mountain. So, but we're going to start tonight with a wonderful trombone to herald in the evening and take us through pain and sorrow and joy and celebration. So enjoy this evening and interact as much as you can. Okay? All right, come on up, Luke.
Thank you. done been here, bless my soul and gone away. My good Lord's done been here, bless my soul and gone. Never did I think that he was so nigh, bless my soul and gone. He spoke and he made me laugh and cry, bless my soul and gone. My good Lord's done been here, bless my soul and gone away. My good Lord's done been here, bless my soul and gone. Sinner, better man, how you walk on the cross, bless my soul and gone. Your foot might slip and your soul get lost, bless my soul and gone. My good Lord's done been here, bless my soul and gone away. My good Lord's done been here, bless my soul and gone. My good Lord's done been here, bless my soul and gone away. My good Lord's done been here, and he blessed my soul, blessed my soul, blessed my soul. Got a home up in that kingdom, ain't that good news? I got a home up in that kingdom, ain't that good news? I'm gonna lay down this world, gonna shoulder up my cross, gonna take it home to my Jesus, ain't that good news? I got a crown up in that kingdom, ain't that good news? I got a crown up in that kingdom, ain't that good news? I'm gonna lay down this world, gonna shoulder up my cross,
gonna take it home to my Jesus. Ain't that good news? I gotta roll up into that kingdom. Ain't that good news? I gotta roll up into that kingdom. Ain't that good news? I'm gonna lay down this world, gonna shoulder up my cross, gonna take it home to my Jesus. Ain't that good news? I got a crown up in that kingdom. Ain't that good news? I got a home up in that kingdom. Ain't that good news?
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
so hard they could not stand. Let my people go, go down, Moses, way down in Egypt's land.
Gonna walk all over, gonna shout
all over God.
you're talking about.
'Cause you got to
give an account in the judgment. You better mind.
You better mind.
Oh, you better mind
how you talk.
Yes, you better mind what you're talking about. 'Cause you've got to
give an account in the judgment. You better mind. Mind my brother.
Oh, you better
mind my sister.
You gotta
give an account in the judgment. You better mind.
You better mind.
Oh, you better
mind how you sing.
Yes, you better mind what you're
singing about.
'Cause you gotta
give an account in the judgment. You better mind.
Cause you've got to
give an account in the judgment. You better mind.
You better mind.
Oh, you better
mind my brother.
Oh, you better
mind my sister.
You got to
give an account in the judgment. You better mind.
You better mind.
Oh, you better
mind how you shout.
Yes, you better mind what you're
shouting about.
'Cause you got to
give an account in the judgment. You better mind.
You better mind.
Oh, you better mind
how you shout.
Yes, you better mind what you're shouting about. 'Cause you got to
give an account in the judgment. You better mind.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Come on, do better than that. Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Firstly, I want to thank Maestro Kevin and Natasha and the Cimarron Opera Company for inviting me to speak about the legacy of the Fisk Jubilee Singers. My name is DeAndre Jones, and I am a native of Guthrie, Oklahoma. I see some Guthrie here. And I had the honor of performing and touring with the Fisk Jubilee Singers as a student, as a music major at Fisk University in Nashville, Tennessee. It was one of my greatest honors to represent and preserve the spirituals with such an historic group. The original Fisk Jubilee Singers were a group of remarkable musicians who pioneered the preservation and popularization of the concert spirituals. Their journey was not an easy one, but their dedication to the craft and their desire to uplift the African American community propelled them to great heights. The Fisk Jubilee Singers were formed in 1871 during a time of significant racial tension in the United States. The group consisted of 9 original members, all students of Fisk University, a historically black college in Nashville, Tennessee. Under the guidance of George L. White, the group's director, they began performing concerts to raise funds for the struggling university. However, they soon caught the attention of a wider audience with their unique blend of African American spirituals and Western classical music, which is what we refer to now as the concert spiritual. Might I also add that in our program, we have Go Tell It on the Mountain. Go Tell It on the Mountain was written by the director of the Jubilee Singers, John W. Work. Okay, John W. Work, the second and the third, were both music professors at Fisk University and composers of Go Tell It on the Mountain, just FYI. In 1873, the Fisk Jubilee Singers embarked on their first tour in the United States, traveling by train to cities across the country. They faced numerous challenges and hardships during their travels, including discrimination, racism, and financial difficulties. They were often refused accommodations in hotels and had to sleep on the floor of train stations. Yet they persevered, determined to share their music with as many people as possible. And might I add here, a lot of African Americans at that time, a lot of black folks at that time, didn't appreciate them sharing the concert spiritual with the world because they felt that it was a sacred experience. And so they got it kind of from both sides, okay? Throughout their tours, the Fisk Jubilee Singers faced constant discrimination and prejudice. They were sometimes forced to perform in separate venues from their white counterparts and were paid far less for their performances. Despite that hardship, they continued to perform and inspire audiences with their music. Ella Shepherd, one of the original members of the group, wrote about the challenges they faced in her memoir, saying, quote, "We had a hard time. I tell you, traveling and singing all the time, we just had to keep on going. We knew that we had something important to share with the world, and we weren't going to let anything stop us," end quote. Another member, Maggie Porter, who was rumored to be the diva of the group, we were not welcome in many of the places we performed, but we sang our hearts out anyway, and people listened. Our music touched them in a way that words never could," end quote. The Fisk Jubilee Singers' dedication to their craft and their perseverance in the face of adversity paved the way for future generations of African American music. Their influence can be heard in the music of artists like Mahalia Jackson, Sam Cooke, Aretha Franklin, and many others. So tonight, as we celebrate the legacy of this art form, the spiritual, let us remember the Fisk Jubilee Singers. and their struggles to bring this art form to the world. Let us continue to honor their legacy, let us continue to honor the dedication and persevering by sharing the spirituals. And let us be unwavered, committing to the art form. I took the liberty in composing a little poem. So I want to share that with you, just a short poem. Hopeful songs of freedom ring as we lift our voices and sing. The spirituals, they bring us together, united as one, sometimes through stormy weather. In times of struggle, pain, and strife, these songs gave hope and brought new life. A reminder of our shared humanity and the power of music's unity. From the chains of slavery to the civil rights fight, the spirituals were a beacon of light, a symbol of hope, shining very, very bright. So let us continue to sing these songs and keep the legacy alive and strong. For in them we find hope, unity, and humanity, and the power to create a world filled with love and equity. Thank you.
The hand of you must go in by the holy
steal away, Study war no more. study war no more. Yeah, study war no more. Study war no more. Ain't gonna study war no more. Gonna put on my long white robe down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by the riverside. Gonna put on my long white robe down by the riverside. Study war no more. It ain't gonna study war no more. Study war no more. Ain't gonna study war no more. Study war no more. Ain't gonna study war no more. Study war no more. Gonna lay it down. Gonna lay it down. Gonna lay it down. Gonna lay it down. Study.
Do you remember me way beyond?
Nora, let me come in. The doors are fastened and the windows pinned. Keep your hand on the plow, hold on. Nora said you done lost your track. You can't plow straight and keep looking back. Keep your hand on the plow, hold on. Hold on, hold on. Keep your hand on the plow, hold on. Mary had a golden chain, every link says my Jesus' name. Keep your hand on the plow, hold on. Nora said you done lost your track. You can't plow straight and keep looking back. Keep your hand on the plow, hold on. Hold on, hold on. If you want to get to heaven, let me tell you how. Keep your hand on the gospel plow. Keep your hand on the plow. Hold on. If that plow stays in your hand, then you'll lead you straight to the promised land. Keep your hand on the plow, hold on, hold on, hold on, keep your hand on the plow, keep your hand on the plow, keep your hand on the plow, and hold
Mr. Smith said earlier, feel free to join in on the chorus if you know it. Clap, tap, snap if the spirit moves you.
Over the hills and everywhere, go so much for joining us for the Festival of Spirituals today. I'm Natasha Nike. I'm Cimarron Opera's Interim Executive Director. We are so glad that this program could return in person this year after 2 years online. If you have friends that couldn't make it today but are still interested in the festival, we will be releasing this year's festival online in a few weeks for even more people to enjoy. This festival was made possible with funding from Norman Arts Council and Allied Arts. We are so thankful to First Presbyterian Church for the use of their beautiful sanctuary and their long-term support for Cimarron Opera. As a nonprofit, we rely on grants and donations to support our programming. If you would like to help Cimarron Opera to continue providing free and affordable arts programming for Oklahoma, please either use the link in your program or see a board member in the lobby after this. Donations to Cimarron Opera are tax deductible. Thank you so much for joining us today. We hope to see you at some programming in the future. Have a wonderful Palm Sunday.